George, I'm with bluefishtoys.com and re-review electronic toys. Lately, we've been looking at quite a few of the Crosley turntables that are being put out today. Most of them have a retro look and are meant to look like they're from the 50s, 60s, or 70s, maybe even the 80s. This one, and they're not super high-end audiophile record players. In response to that, Crosley now has one called the Crosley Advance. It's a somewhat higher level turntable, not the highest level. It's not like a $4,000 turntable or anything like that. But it is a higher quality turntable. It's got a better needle and a better cartridge, better controls, better everything. And we're going to open it up and see how it works. Great. Freaking now. Very orange. That was a frightening sound. That's a felt. Whoa! Oh, this is for the back of the tone arm. It's the counterweights for the tone arm. Tone arm? Well, here we go. We've got it at least partially set up. I decided to stop here and show a few things. One thing was a little bit annoying, and I'm not sure that we're the first person to have owned this particular model, because there are parts of it that look like they might have been repacked. But the power cable was actually shoved through between the plastic cover and the actual turntable, and it was a dickens to bend that plastic cover enough to get that power cable out of there without breaking it, but we did manage to do it. This is the tone arm counterbalance. It comes packed up separately, and that's going to get mounted onto the tone arm here. It's got an anti-skeeting control. It's got, the tone arm is currently held down with the twisty, so let's undo that twisty and get rid of it. And then for safety, it's got, like most tone arms, it's got the little clip that you clip out of the way to allow that tone arm to come free and play on the record player. We'll just close that up again. It's got the speed controls for 33, 45, and 78. It's got a felt mat for giving the records a fairly nice, safe, soft ride on the turntable. It's got the dots and so forth in place and a strobe light on the side so you can actually adjust the speed to be exactly 45 RPM or 33 and a third or 78. And we'll try all that out afterwards. So we're going to leave this for now. We're going to take the tape off the cartridge. Again, this is their higher level offering from Crosley. It's got probably their best cartridge as far as needles and so forth go. It's actually made by a well-known higher end cartridge company. And you can buy replacements for it. And when you buy the replacement for this unit, it actually comes, it's called the NP5. And here is a copy of what the replacement needle looks like right now. And we'll finish putting it together, and we'll put some records on it, run it through. It does not have its own internal amplifier or speakers like a lot of the other Crosleys do. It is a standalone turntable. It's meant to be plugged into your sound system and playing records that way. So we'll get that all set up, and we'll try it out, and we'll see how it goes. So one of the things that the Crosley Advance has is it has an adjustment at the back here that comes in a, it comes separate. You have to install this yourself when you get the record player out of the box. And what you want to do is to figure out what it actually has a little scale on it, which is in grams, going from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up to 5 or 6. When you install it, you basically screw it on from the back end. Like that. It literally just comes off like that. So you're going to put it on till you feel it stop, and then you screw it on. And what you see is because it's a counterweight for the head shell, is it adjusts how much weight is on the record on the actual needle. So what you want to do is you want to find that point where it just barely touches the record. So I'll move it forward. You see it right now, it's a little bit light, so I'll move it forward a bit more. Now it's got a little bit of weight. back it off a little bit. And there it is, free floating right there. So I would call that right now 0 grams. And we're going to turn it now. And if you look at the back here, once you've got it set up to that point, I already had it set up. This black dial spins on its own without moving the counterweight back and forth. So once you've got it to that point where it's free floating just over the record, nice and even, you want to set that dial to 0. Now when you turn the counterweight forward, putting more weight on the front, when you get to the 1, that should be theoretically 1 gram. And what we've done to allow us to test this, we brought ourselves in a small scale, and we'll turn that on now. It auto zeros. And we bring it across. You want to do this really gently. You're putting the needle right on this scale. So just put it down very gently. And you'll see that the scale says we've got 1.01 grams. Actually, almost, that's 1.00 grams. So you got to be happy with that. That's actually pretty accurate. For that dial at the back to be on a 1, and the scale actually says it's 1.01 or 1.00 grams, I'm pretty happy with that. So I'm going to lift it up. I'm going to turn the back now to 2 grams. And now we'll stop at the 2. We'll gently put the needle back down. I can definitely feel more weight on my finger. And the scale says 2.11 grams. So that's pretty close. I mean, not necessarily I'm dead on at the very back either, because I'm kind of doing it by eye. But you certainly get the general feeling that it's pretty accurate, that when it says 1 or 2 or 3, that's the kind of weight that's going to be put on the record. So I'm pretty happy with that. Okay, what we've done, we've hooked up the Crosley Advanced Turntable to our home test system. If you remember from our other reviews, a lot of the other Crosleys are portable turntables, they're record players. They have built-in amplifiers and built-in speakers, and you can carry them around and play music wherever you go. This unit is actually meant to be your actual main turntable for your home stereo system. It has to have an exterior amplifier that it plugs into, and it has 2 RCA out jacks to do that. So we've hooked it up here, we picked an old 45, so we'll throw that on, and we'll see how it sounds.
We get it almost every night. And when that moon gets big and bright, it's supernatural delight. Every border we're dancing in the moonlight. Everybody here is out of sight, but they don't bark and they don't bite. They keep things loose, they keep things alive. Every part of us dancing in the moonlight.
Dancing in the moonlight. Everybody's feeling warm and bright. It's such a fine and natural sight. Everybody's dancing in the moonlight.
We like a fun and we never fight.
As you can imagine, we already set up the strobe light on the side for the speed and so forth to adjust the speed to get it exactly 45, and that's what it's running at right now. We've tried several records and albums, and it has performed, in my opinion, quite flawlessly and run really good. The sound sounds good, the bass is great. Depends on how you kind of condition your records in and so forth. You certainly have a scratchy record, it's going to sound scratchy because that's how records play. But generally we're very happy with it.
What I want to show you on this, on the Advance by Crosley, is it does have over on the side here, it does have the stroboscope and the strobe points on the turntable that allow you to set the speed very specifically. Over on the right here, we have a pitch adjustment which adjusts the speed. It has a 0 point in the middle. So what you can do is you put your record on, like for example, this one's set to 33 1/3. Put a record on. And over in the stroboscope, and I'm not sure the camera's going to pick it up properly or not, but you adjust the speed until there's multiple rows of dots going around. You'll see one that's very close to already stopping. So you adjust the pitch to get that row to completely stop. And now you know you're going exactly 33 1/3. And if we turn our speakers up a little bit so we can hear the music. I'm going to adjust the speed, and you'll actually hear the speed of the record change. Slow it down. And that speeds it up. So you can't just assume that the middle is the right position right there, because based on the stroboscope, I can see that it's running a little bit fast. So I'm gonna slow it down just a bit to stop that strobe from moving. And that's perfect 33 and a third right there. Let's cover a few of the details on this record player one last time. It's got the stroboscope and the dots on the platen that allows you to use the speed control that when it's running, you can exactly set your speed for 45 RPM or 33 and a third RPM. That works really, really well. We had no issue with that at all. It's got a true magnetic cartridge and stylus made by a well-known company, Audio Technica. They've been in business for years and years and years, making pretty decent quality cartridges and needles. It's got speed control for 33 and a third, 45 and 78. It's got the dampened up and down lever for lifting the needle up and down off the record very gently rather than trying to use your hands. Or if you've got kids, I would definitely suggest telling them that they've got to use that so it's easier on your records. And what I mean by dampened is that when you go to drop it, it lowers very nice and gently onto the record surface. It's got the balance control for the weight on the back of the tone arm right here. And as we showed earlier in the video, that works really well and it's very accurate for what it does. And lastly, it's got the anti-skid control over here. And what that is, just basically because of physics, when you put something on a turning turntable like that, its natural tendency is to throw it out, which puts a little more weight and pressure on the outside edge of each record groove that it's playing in. The anti-skate sets to offset that to keep the record needle, the record player needle centered in the groove rather than putting weight on either side of the groove wall. And that all seems to work pretty good. And lastly, it's got the smoked plastic lip that's all hinged. Okay, that concludes our review of the Crosley Advanced Turntable. The only other thing I wanted to mention is, again, the feet on the very bottom of it are all spring-loaded. And the whole idea being of that is that it'll absorb some shocks from the table and other items making sounds in your house. So rather than have them come up through the turntable and get picked up by the needle on the record, that'll help dampen that down quite a bit. I'm George. I'm with bluefishtoys.com and re-review electronic toys. See, that's why you're there. I could be back. You like this.
Yeah, it'd be better.
Okay.